बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन एंड द टॉपिक्स विल बी कवर्ड मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन, एजुकेशन सेक्रेटेरिएट, प्रिवेंशन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशन, सेक्रेटेरिएट्स ऑफ एजुकेशन, डायरेक्ट्रेट्स पब्लिक इंस्ट्रक्शंस इन विच स्कूल्स और कॉलेजेस विल बी डिस्कस्ड। Then federal government education institutions, in Kent and garrisons schools are included. First of all, pre 18th amendment. This was actually the Ministry of Education as playing the central role, and that's why this was a central organization which was was responsible for formulating national education policies and for development of national education. The ministry also played the role of provincial coordinator of educational departments for policy making and other functions also. Ministry of Education that is normally headed by Federal Minister of Education, who was the member of the cabinet and normally represented by Ministry of Education in the parliament or a similar body at the federal level. Education was in concurrent legislative list, so it was a joint function of federal as well as provincial. So at federal level it was the responsibility of Ministry of Education for formulation of its policies, plans and also the national curriculum for it, while provinces develop their own policies, plans and curriculum in the light of guidelines which normally receives from the federal government. Then post 18th amendment, after 18th amendment means Act 2010 that has been introduced a number of changes in constitution of Pakistan, which is now prevailing, 1973. It has redefined the existing nature of relationship between the federal and the federating units in Pakistan. The distribution of powers has profound impacts for the legislative jurisdiction and executive authorities at federal and provincial levels. Education, this is the one of the key subjects which are being developed to the provincial level. The present change in the constitution entails a shift in the nature of relations between the federal and provincial governments in as much as governance of education is concerned. So the result is a significant shift in the roles and responsibilities of the federation and the federating units. The 18th Constitutional Amendments Act 2010 has introduced some significant changes having direct bearing on the education sector. As a result of omission of a concurrent legislative list, main areas of education policy, planning, curriculum, standards, center of excellence and Islamic education have been developed to the provincial ambit. Moreover, the 18th Constitutional Amendment has revised the existing framework of distribution, means distribution of powers between federal government and federating units. And education has been shifted to the legislative and executive jurisdiction of the provinces. And then Ministry of Federal Education and Professional Training, this is a federal ministry of Government of Pakistan. The ministry political figure that is known as the Education Minister of Pakistan. Education, this is the primarily provincial in Pakistan, because most of the things are being taken or done at provincial level regarding education. And the Ministry of Professional and Technical Training, as it was developed in July 2011, and this was in the wake of 18th amendment when education department was transferred from federal to provinces. In 2013 it was renamed to Ministry of Education, Training and Standards in Higher Education, and in 2014 that was renamed to Ministry of Federal Education and Professional Training. The department's main responsibilities include creating policies, plans and programs to ensure the accessibility and availability of education in Pakistan. It is also a provider of many technical, vocational and provincial professional skills and training that are needed to satisfy the national and international standards of the employment market. It works in collaboration with other ministries and organizations by sponsoring students, distributing scholarships and conducting multiple training sessions. Sub-departments under the Ministry of Education and Training include National Vocational and Technical Training Commission, National Commission for Human Development, National Education Funding, National Education Assessment System. Then Education Secretariat is there. Like in pre-18 amendment, the Federal Education Secretary was the Chief Executive of the Education Secretariat. He remains responsible for the administration of his secretariats and for implementation of government decisions and policies relating to education. After 18th amendment, education has become independent responsibility of provinces. So the Secretary of Education at federal level is responsible only in certain areas. Pakistan, this is the federation of four provinces like Punjab, Sindh, KPK and Balochistan. And according to the constitution, education in Pakistan is a provincial concern. Before 18th amendment, we know that provinces are, as a matter of principle, independent in policy formulation and management of education within their administrative boundaries. In practice, major education policies were formulated at federal level and they were passed on to the provincial education department for implementation. After 18th amendment, education has been included in the legislative and executive list, so it has become totally the provincial responsibility. There is a Federal Ministry of Education who is responsible for the federal matters of education, Punjab, Sindh, KPK and Balochistan. They have their independent ministries of education and they develop their own education policies. The provincial secretaries of education, you know that these are independent in matters especially related to education, and the purpose and function of departments of education are more or less similar in all the provinces depending on the local conditions and needs. They differ to some extent and vary from each other in organizations and management structure. So there is some organizational management structure of Department of Education, like Punjab as an example. We show a flow chart that gives almost same in other. Like first of all, Ministry of Education is head by ministry, and then secretary and minister of states, and then additional secretary, admin wing, policy and planning wing, curriculum wing, projects wing, training wing and monitoring cell is there. So total number of offices that is 115 and total number of staff that is 336. In directorates, public instructions, the administration of schools and colleges in the province rest with the directorates of public instructions, schools and colleges. So some of the brief history of DPI that is given below, like Directorate of Public Instruction that was established in 1856, and since then it is functioning. So in 1956, when the four provinces like Punjab, Sindh, NWFP and Balochistan were merged and named as West Pakistan, the Directorate of Public Instructions was renamed as Director Public Instructions West Pakistan and four regional directorates, that is Lahore, Peshawar, Quetta and Hyderabad, were set up. So in 1962, the regional directorate Lahore was further bifurcated into two regions, that is Lahore region, means Lahore, Multan, Bahawalpur divisions, and Rawalpindi region, where Rawalpindi and Sargodha divisions was there. In 1973, education department was reorganized with five divisional directorates, means Lahore, Rawalpindi, Multan, Bahawalpur and DG Khan. Later on, the number of divisions raised to eight. Like in 1982, the provincial directorate was further divided to two separate independent functions units, that is DPI colleges and DPI schools. In 1993, on the recommendations of international donor agencies, Directorate of Public Instruction Schools was further divided into three wings, like DPI Secondary Education, DPI Elementary Education, and Directorate of Staff Development, means training wing. Divisional directorates abolished in 2001, and school education devolved to district government's Directorate of Public Instruction Colleges. That is in an attached department, and that performs a coordinating role between the secretariat and district education office, and an augmenting role in policy formulation, administrative as well as financial matters. DPI, this is assisted by the additional DPI and four directors, means planning, academic, administration male and administration female. Key function performed by the DPI can be listed, like implement government policies, directions and orders, and to assess the needs and requirements of the colleges and provisions of funds, staff and buildings. To assist the government in formulating policies in respect of academics, financial and administrative matters. To act as coordinator between the government and other agencies, including the director, means or the district education offices, colleges. Maintenance of the career record of teaching staff of colleges, BPS 17, 18, 19 and 20, and preparation of their promotion. Administer inter-degree and post-graduate colleges. Arrangements for teacher training. Registration of private colleges. Conduct of inquiries, settlement of audit paras, technical and administrative inspection of colleges, inter-district transfers of teaching and non-teaching staff up to BPS 19, sanction of leave up to maximum of 365 days up to BPS 20, except ex-Pakistan leave. So this is the organization chart of DPI. Where you can say DPI Punjab, like is there ADP 1, Director Admin Wing, and then the Director P&B. So then under ADP, there are different Assistant Directors, and Director Admin has Assistant Director Admin, Assistant Director Committee, Assistant Director Committee 2, Committee 3, and so on. So this is basically organization chart, and we can assess that how the persons are working under the commands. Now, what is mission? Mission of federal government education institutions, Kents and Garrisons, means this, they have missions like to provide purposeful and quality education to the wards of armed forces personnel, as well as of civilians residing in cantonments or garrisons throughout the country, by nurturing fine citizens skills among the students and providing the healthy educational environment so as to make them useful members of the society. They have core values like instilling in the students moral, social and national values so as to help them becoming good human beings and patriotic Pakistanis, grooming them to be educationally sound, to adjust as effective as and productive members of the society. Making the students physically and mentally robust by providing facilities of sports and co-curricular activities. Realizing the fact that in FGEIs, children generally come from the lower social strata of the society, this deserves our utmost care in their nurturing. And if we introduce, so we can say that educational institutions of Kent boards all over Pakistan were taken over by Federal Ministry of Education in 1975. Then in September 1977, the administrative and financial control of these schools and colleges was transferred to DAE, means Director Army Education. Subsequently, in November 1981, separate directorate was created that was under IGT&E branch to deal exclusively with the affairs of the federal government. Educational institutions under FGEIs, then Kent and Garrisons. Recently, FGEIs directorate has been declared as an attached department of Ministry of Defence, DEI, exercise administrative and financial control over the department. And its employees through the authority delegated to him under the cabinet division letter issued in September 1977. So this is a fundamental documents which spell out the functions of this directorate. FGI directorate has a dual role. On the one hand, it is a directorate of GHQ. On the other hand, it is attached civil department of Ministry of Defence with 99.5% of its employees being paid out of civil establishment. The employees of FGEIs are governed by the civil services rules and enjoy protection to the extent that their cases of indiscipline and inefficiency can't be dealt with the expeditiously. So they have a right of appeal before the Federal Service Tribunal against any decisions. For appointment and disciplinary actions, the authority of the director is rested to the employees of BPS 15 and below. For gazetted employees in BPS 16 and above, the authority for regular appointments, promotions and disciplinary actions rests totally with the Ministry of Defence, Establishment Divisions and Federal Public Service Commission. However, the director FGI enjoys full powers of posting and transfers in respect of all categories of the civil employees, organization of FGI, directorate of organizations of the directorate. That is, like director brigadier, that is having two types of staff, military staff and civil staff. In military staff, they have deputy directors, normally it is colonel, GSO1, GSO2, steno, in which JCU or NCOs are there, and driver is there. And in civil staff, deputy director colleges, deputy director male, deputy director females, financial and established officer, admin officer, superintendents, and other staff is there. Role of FGI directorate. The role of FGI directorate is that is to exercise all administrative control over FGIs in Kent and Garrisons with a view to providing better educational facilities, primarily to the children of servicing persons and civilians residing in Kent areas. And if we talk about the functions of FGI's directorate, so this directorate performs different functions like implementation of national education policy, laying down of uniform syllabi, textbooks and schedule of examinations. However, syllabi and schedule of matric, FFSC, BA, BSc, MA exams are controlled by FPISE and the universities. Maintenance of high academic standards and quality of education, selection and recruitment of categories of all categories of teaching and non-teaching staff except grade 16 and above. Management, posting, promotions, transfer, welfare and disciplinary administrative actions regarding civil staff. Promotion or disciplinary action against grade 16 and above are dealt with by Ministry of Defence and Establishment Divisions. Preparation and processing of budget establishment, annual development programs, plans in respect of FGIs and procurement of necessary funds from the Ministry of Defence. Execution of development projects through MES. Regional offices, FGI's directorate has 8 sanctioned regional offices throughout the country. An additional regional offices has been established at Gujranwala and Bahawalpur, and its government section is in progress. Out of 9 regions, 4 regions are headed by army officers, in which lieutenant colonels are heading, and 5 regions by civil officers. So at present, following regional offices are functioning under GSOs 1, Deputy Director Civils like Peshawar, Wagh, Quetta and Karachi under GSOs 1, Lieutenant Colonels there. Rawalpindi, Mangla, Multan, Lahore, Gujranwala and Bahawalpur, that is the organization of regional offices as under, like Lieutenant Colonel 1, Deputy Director, Major GSOs 2, Assistant Director, then they have two under commands, education JCOs and administrative officers and superintendents. Then education JCOs, there are two ORs and administrative officer or superintendent, they have clerical or ministerial staff. The number of institutions presently being run by federal government, education institutions, directorates in 11 regions throughout Pakistan, where the primary schools are there, model schools are there, high schools are there, inter-college female, inter-college co-education, degree college male, degree college female, and degree college co-education. Inshallah, we will continue it with the next topics. And still, if you didn't subscribe my channel, so please subscribe it. I have given you some important links given in description. You can join those channel also for your information or for the notes of this B8 or different subjects. And you can also visit our websites where notes and MCQs are also available. That is pakshines.com. Shine ke saath apne S lagana hai. और उसको आप देखें, वहाँ पे आपको हर चीज़ मिलेगी। आपने अगर कहीं क्या कम्पिटेटिव एग्ज़ाम देना है तो वहाँ पे आप, हमारा मोबाइल एप्लीकेशन है उसको आप इंस्टॉल कर लें, ठीक है, और उसको कंटिन्यू करें। उसमें बहुत सारी चीज़ें आपके लिए हमने रखी हैं। तो दुआ में याद रखें, अपना ख्याल रखें। अल्लाह हाफिज़।